Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Leslie, and today I have an Echo Park Paper Company unboxing here. This is something that I bought when they were having their warehouse sale, and so let's just go ahead and get started. I'm starting out showing you that it did come with a little catalog here of some of their upcoming things, so if you're interested in that. And then this is my list of all the things. I did have a couple things that didn't work out, apparently got refunded because they ran out. That's the problem. That's the only thing with warehouse sales, is that you don't always know if you're gonna get everything you want, but I did get quite a bit. So I'll start with the ephemera. This is the Fall Fevers, the frames and tags. I'm not gonna get everything out just because there is a lot, but this will just kind of give you a glimpse. I also got that little nativity one. I'm not sure which one this is called. It's called the First Noel. And then we have the Play All Day Girl for the frames and tags. I love the little pinks, those are pretty. And then I did find a Christmas one that is called Christmas Salutations. And then we have another Fall Fever. This is the ephemera instead of the other one was frames and tags. When I bought this, I was really looking forward of doing some fall photos, but I kind of missed that with all the shipping. This is my favorite winter. I really like the reds and the purples in this. Another my favorite winter. One was the frames and tags, and one was the ephemera. And then this one is the magic of winter. So this one has more of the blues and the whites. I got actually a bundle in that one because I loved everything in it. The other one, I only got a sticker sheet, which you can kind of see here. And then I am going to show you the paper pads. This is the Fall Fever one. I decided I needed to open all of them. I love showing off paper. Ooh, and I love that first one, flower one. It does have some cut apart pieces, which is really nice. Those make really quick cards. And I just really like the color scheme. Echo Park does great with their paper pads and just the colors that they have that match. Not necessarily ones that I would have automatically gone, oh yeah, that matches perfectly. It works out. And of course, sunflowers. if you know me at all, sunflowers are like my favorite flower. Is also why fall is probably my favorite season, because all the sunflowers come out. but you do get 24 double-sided papers, so about, I want to say there's 12 or 13 designs. Yeah, about 13 different designs on there. So I'm just showing all of that. Oh, how cute. All the little symbols there. And then, of course, that flower print is probably my favorite. So, and then this is the birthday girl pad. I have daughters, of course, and then I also have nephews. So I did get one pad specifically for all the little girls in my life, because I'm also part of some mom groups that all have girls, or almost all girls. So I make a lot of birthday cards for girls, and so I just wanted a paper pad specifically for that. And I really love the colors. This is almost kind of rainbow, so this, it doesn't necessarily have to be for girls, it could be for boys as well, because of all the rainbow prints. And there's even some orange and green and less feminine colors, but it also has some of those cut aparts, which would make quick cards too. So I'm excited to be using this. I like how that they have a lot of tone-on-tone prints as well. Just makes it easier to kind of calm down some of the bigger prints, even though that's beautiful. I just really like to be able to mix and match with that. And look, little elephants, guys. That's so cute. And then this is the Play All Day for boys. Like I said, I have nephews, and anything to do with trucks or dinosaurs or Legos or cars, yeah, this is right up their alley. So these will make some fun cards for them and any males in my life, or even females in my life. I have my daughters love dinosaurs and Legos and trucks as well, so they'd probably be ecstatic to get a card like this. Well, my 3-year-old would love any card So I always show her the cards that I make, and she always goes, "Beautiful, Mama." So if you ever need like a good encouragement, you know, she's the one to go to. I really like the dinosaurs in this. It's really cute. And then some of the open spaces with those little cut-up parts would make a good place for sentiments and stuff like that. So that'll be really nice. And then I love that Reach for the Stars. I actually just got a stamp set from Concord and Ninth that is along the space theme, so that'll go together well. And this last one is called Undersea Adventures. And of course I had to buy this one because my second daughter, her birth theme, nursery theme, is ocean. So specifically with octopus is her animal. And so I'm just showing you here, a lot of these are tone on tone. They're just really like small detail. So I'm trying to show you that with the camera. You see some waves there, but I thought this would just be perfect to be using with her scrapbook. I know it kind of has some more like boyish colors, but I can make that work. And plus, you know, in our house we love all colors, so it works out. But again, there's lots of tone on tone, there's lots of cut apart, so I can make some cards with this, and of course I will, because I have a lot of under the sea themed things. But I do plan on using most of this for her scrapbook, so I'm excited to be able to use that. Plus her and my older daughter, they had their birthday together because they're only 4 days apart. So their birthday this year was under the sea themed. So I'll be able to use that with their birthday pages as well for both of them. So I'm really excited to use it. Oh, I love that one. Okay, so then we have the sticker sheets. Now these were individual sheets that I bought so that I would have some more things to work with cards for those paper pads. So I did get that favorite winter, and then I got my favorite fall, which is different from the fall fever, but it still had some similar colors. More that Christmas salutations, which I'm really excited to use these for some Christmas photos, either this year or next year at this point. And then of course birthday wishes. I felt like this had both feminine and masculine colors, so that was really nice. And then of course the under the sea. They only had the 6x6 pad and the sticker pad for the under the sea. Otherwise I would have got a full bundle like this one. I love winter. This and this just speaks to my heart with the little penguins and little mugs of hot cocoa and just super cute. I'm not going to open all of these just because it's a lot and we don't want this video to be forever. So I did get coffee themed. I'm getting more and more into coffee themed cards and the such. I actually have a couple new stamp sets that I'm going to be working with. So I'm really excited to be able to use these papers here. And then the magic of winter, that I did have a I got the ephemera and the frames with this one as well to make some of those wintry cards, which I'm excited about. Do you see that little tiny owl? That's so cute. I love it. I love it all. And then this is the new day bundle. There's a lot of florals. Do you see those cameras? Cameras and florals, guys. This just speaks to my heart. There's little bumblebees, just all kinds of little cute things that I think will be great for spring. So I'm going to get started. I am going to make a card for you today. I'm using that the magic of winter. Like I said, this is the ephemera and the whole bundle here. So I will actually walk you through this bundle. That'll give you an idea of what the other bundles contain. But it does start with that sticker sheet as well, which I end up actually using just the sticker sheet and not the ephemera for the card, just because I liked what I found in there better. So that worked out. I love the little penguins. Aren't they so cute? And all the little snowflakes. And I really love this color scheme too. So they have a lot of that almost tone on tone, some snowflakes, some little pine needles, a lot of that blue and dark blue, some snowmen with little trees, that's cute. Looks like little snowflakes or stars. They do have some cut apart pieces that can make some quick cards. We're not going to use them today, but that will be, you know, soon. Some bigger patterns here. I love all the little snowflakes, guys. This is going to be great. Oh, I love the penguins. It's so pretty. And then we have some dark tone on tone with some more cut aparts. I love hot cocoa. And so that hot cocoa and fuzzy socks, I'm here for it. that is my winter theme of life there. some more tone on tone. I love the tone on tone because you can really see the little detail and it just kind of gives you some more look. I accidentally grabbed a couple pages there that was showing you the other sides with the hardwood floor page, and then some more cut aparts there. I love the little penguin that says hello winter. Yeah, I'm hoping for snow. I might be the only person. I love snow if we can play in it and build snowmen and go sledding kind of thing. I don't like blizzard and just ice and rainy and grossness, so hopefully we get good, like, nice snow this year. We'll see. So I am going to start out by making my card here. I am using a Mojo Monday. It's 548. That's the sketch that I'm using today. I changed it up a little bit because I wanted to mat on my little pattern paper just to give some more space in between them since I am using multiple patterns. So that first little one is about 1.5 by 2.25, and then the bigger square is 2.5 by 3, and then this long piece is 2 inches by 5.25, and then the pattern paper is going to be just 4 by 5.25. I'm making a normal A2 size card, which is the 5.5 by 4.25. So then I am just gonna go ahead. I'm using tape runner. There we go. That's the word. tape runner as my adhesive. And then of course I did realize I needed my ribbon to go across here before I put that pattern paper on my card base. I'm using ribbon instead of just another piece of paper, just to give it a little bit more fun there. Plus I had one that matched, so it was perfect. I'm pretty sure this one actually was a bow on a present that one of my girls received for their birthdays, and I'm like, I can use that on a card. I'm just figuring out where it's not creased, just so the creases don't show on that front. And then I had a little bit of that tape runner on there, but then I'm also going to just put some scotch tape just over the ribbon just to make sure it's secure. And then add a little bit more of that tape runner and place that pattern paper on my card base there. and then a little bit of that runner underneath the ribbon because it was coming apart a little bit. And then I'm just kind of setting up how I want the pieces to go. It's not exactly with a sketch. I tend to use sketch kind of as inspiration and then kind of do my own thing, thus the matting. Most of the matting, I believe, was just 1/4 inch there. And then I am going to add some layers of cardstock to this paper just so it doesn't get warped with that ribbon and with the pattern paper beneath it. I end up putting 2, I believe, layers on that. I just put some tape runner on the one, kind of line it up, and then stick the second one on there. And then I'm just going to put tape runner on all of it and press it down onto my card front there. And then I am going to do something similar with this one. I'm just going to do a thinner piece there, just so it, again, all lays flat. Makes it a little bit smoother and a little bit cleaner then. So I'm just kind of lining up that paper. I'm going to stick it on there here. Maybe I will try here. And then if there's any overhang, I'm just going to cut it off. Just make sure that it's in the right position. And then I'll just add another piece. Since I did mat on my pattern paper, I do need 2 layers here. So I'm just repeating the process, using my tape runner, sticking that down, lining it all up, getting glue everywhere, of course. I just love how these pattern papers actually worked out real well. A lot of those tone on tones, this is where I get to really use them, shine here. I am cutting down just a normal 8.5 by 11 sheet, down to the 5.5 by that 8.5 piece. And then I'm going to score at the 4.25, just using my bone folder there. We are making a portrait style, of course, as you can see. And so I'm just going to take my card layer and stick it onto the card base using just my tape runner. Just lining it up in that corner and actually making it even. A lot of times I have to trim because I can't quite get it even, but it's okay. And then, like I said, we are going to use some stickers for this. So I decided to go with Dashing Through the Snow. I think that is super cute. And then I am bringing in some embellishments. I believe this was just some glitter that I got from Hobby Lobby. It has some snowflakes in it that are hollow. And so I'm adding about 3 there. Around the sentiment, and then I'm going to add a few more snowflake stickers just to kind of give it a little bit more, you know, a little bit more shine, a little bit more interest. And then that's my card for today. So if you enjoyed this unboxing, let me know. If you enjoyed this card, let me know. Hit the like button, comment below. What are you guys doing for holidays? Anything fun? Just talk to me. All right, I will see you guys in a next video soon. I hope you have a great day. Hit that like, hit that bell. I'll see you later.